is fascinating about the pathology is we know about the disease, its cause, its effect, and helping clinicians arriving at the correct diagnosis so that proper treatment can be given to the patient.
I started my journey as pathology resident in this college in 2011. Now I am working here as associate professor.
I saw the transformation of the small department to the most advanced pathology lab.
It is basically divided into three main branches, that is hematopathology, histopathology and cytopathology.
In our college, we have continuous rotation amongst the three subsections, that is cytology, hematology and histopathology, so that we don't lose touch with one particular subject.
So in our department, we also have rotational postings in blood bank, microbiology and biochemistry.
JR1 pathology currently posted in hematology section with my co-JR Sujit. Our day usually starts at 8 to 8:30 in the morning. First thing we do here after coming is to check quality control of every machine.
We receive around 300 samples daily.
In which there are 100 to 150 IPD samples and 100 to 150 OPD samples. We make PVS of every sample and review it under the microscope.
We get exposure of every type of slide, such as normal to anemia.
Also we get to see every type of leukemias here.
Here not only we do the CBC and the hematology examination, we also do the clinical pathological examinations.
In clinical pathology, we do CSF examinations, semen analysis, urine routine, rural food and aside. Usually we get 50 to 60 urine samples every day here, and we have urine auto-analyzer in our department.
So we have urine auto-analyzer. But we also do the routine light microscopy of the urine. Daily we have 1 to 2 patients for the semen analysis, and we counsel them accordingly.
We have highly equipped grossing station. Here grossing is being done. Daily we receive 20 to 30 specimens from different departments. These vary from the neoplastic to non-neoplastic specimens like gallbladder, appendix, to major oncosurgery specimens like colonic cancer, breast cancer. After receiving the specimen, we keep it for overnight fixation. Next day, we gross it. As the juniors write description, we get exposed to the histopathological specimen since the first year.
In the histopath reporting, basically we get the slides of the previous day's grossing at around 2 in the afternoon. We residents are supposed to scan the slides the previous day itself, the day we get the tree. And next morning, the same slides are reported upon the decahead with the professors, assistant professors and the lecture. We can cross-check what points we missed and read it after going to the room again.
Himself as a pathologist, I had a basic idea about this field. But after coming here, since this is a tertiary hospital, I got to know new things like immunohistochemistry and frozen section.
Margins, or we get a lot of ovaries, which are ovarian tumors, we diagnose, and depending upon that, management is decided. Also, we get lymph nodes, then brain tumors. Recently, we have started getting, like, depending upon the operations performed. Those are the specimens which we get.
I also got to learn about reporting of specimens like brain tumors. These things are not just present here for namesake, but these things are reported accurately by the faculty.
As you all know, that blood is an integral part of the human medicine, and it is right now considered as an important branch of medicine. As there is an advance of technology, the knowledge in this field is also increasing, and for this purpose, we generally have that particular type of different duties. We give the 2 months special training for the PGs here. We follow all the standard operating procedures which are been laid down by the SBTC. We have got a very eminent blood transfusion officers. We also arrange different blood camps also. Blood camp we nearly arrange 10 to 15 camps in month.
Clinicians send patient to us for FNSC. Our PG residents do FNSC procedure, and they hand over slides to the technician for the staining and further procedure. Then slides are available within hours for reporting. First PG resident do the screening of the slides. Then next day morning, lecturers and associate professors, they do reporting of the all cytology slides including FNSC, pap smear and few.
Our department have arranged many conferences like MAPCON and international CMAs of Oncopath.
In our 3 years of residency, we have to present one oral paper, one poster, and also one publication.
SKNMC, we have more of IHCs, which I was not exposed in JSS Medical College. I think a life as a faculty is a bit different. There is more teaching chances. It is very nice to interact with the residents.
In this era of super specializations, we have many options of PM and fellowships like oncopathology, hematopathology, and one can pursue his or her career in these branches.